Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will see some examples of metric with proofs. And before that, we need a few inequalities which will be very useful in proving those metric. So the first inequality is Holder's inequality, and the second one is Minkowski inequality. And then we will see the proofs of metric spaces. We see the examples and their proof. So let me start with Holder's inequality. This inequality states that we have xi and yi greater than or equals to 0 for all I equals to 1 to n, and p and q are two numbers which are greater than 1. And those numbers are such that 1 upon p plus 1 upon q equals to 1, then this inequality is known as Holder's inequality. This is Holder's inequality. Okay, and here if we take p equals to q, if p equals to q equals to 2, then this inequality becomes summation I equals to 1 to n xi yi is less than or equals to summation I equals to 1 to n xi square to the power 1 by 2 and yi square summation I equals to 1 to n yi square to the power 1 by 2. So this inequality, Holder's inequality, becomes this inequality, and this inequality is also known as Cauchy squares inequality. So this inequality is called Cauchy squares inequality. This inequality is very useful, and we will use it in this lecture. Okay, let's come to the Minkowski inequality. So Minkowski inequality states that we have xi's and yi's greater than or equals to 0 for I equals to 1 to n, and p is greater than or equals to 1, and then this inequality is known as Minkowski inequality. So these two inequalities are very useful, and we will use these two inequalities in this lecture. Okay, so the first example that we have given in the last lecture was the function dxy, which was defined by this, the absolute value of x minus y, and xy belongs to R. So this d is a function from R cross R to R. So let's see that this is a metric. Let's prove that. Okay, so to prove that this is a metric, we have to show those four properties of a metric. That means these four properties: dxy must be greater than or equals to 0, dxy equals to 0 for implies and only implies x equals to y, and these two properties, symmetry and triangle inequality. So let's see the first property. So the first property is what? So let's see the proof. First property is dxy is greater than or equals to 0, which is trivial because of the absolute value function. Because this, by the definition of absolute value function, this is always greater than or equals to 0. So that's why this is dxy is always greater than or equals to 0 by the definition of absolute value function. So this is trivial. Second is dxy equals to 0. So this means that this happens if and only if x minus y, absolute value of x minus y, is 0. And this happens only if x equals to y. So if dxy equals to 0, so this implies and only implies x equals to y. So second one is also done. So third property now. So third property is dxy. So dxy is the absolute value of x minus y. And this is same as the absolute value of y minus x. So this is dyx. So symmetry is also there. Now let's see the fourth property. So fourth property is dx. Well, let's take dxy. Dxy is what? X minus y. And I can write this as x minus z plus z minus y. And I can club these two and these two. So now this is, let's say this is a and this is b. So this is absolute value of a plus b. So we can use the inequality that absolute value of a plus b is less than or equals to absolute value of a plus absolute value of b. So using this inequality, I can write this as less than or equals to absolute value of x minus z plus absolute value of z minus y. So this is also done. So fourth triangle inequality is also satisfied. So that's mean D defined by this is a matrix. Okay, now let's take the second example that we have given. So the second example was this dxy equals to this. Okay, so dxy, our function was defined like this, dxy equals to summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus yi square whole power 1 by 2, right, where xy belongs to Rn and x is what? X is x1, x2, xn, y is y1, y2, yn, right, and d is defined from rn cross rn to r, right. So we'll show that this is a matrix on rn. Okay, let's see the proof. So first property is, so as you can see that here we have square, right, xi minus yi square. So we will always get positive, non-negative value, right. So we will always get non-negative value. So that means dxy, we cannot get a negative value here. So we will get positive value always. So we will get positive value, right. So dxy, non-negative value, right. So dxy is greater than or equals to 0 for all xy belongs to Rn. This is trivial. Second is that dxy equals to 0. So dxy equals to 0, this happens if and only if, let's see this, the definition of dxy, d. So we have the each term here in this summation, the each term is positive because we have a square here. So each term is positive, and if this is 0, d is 0 means that this is 0, and since each term is positive, therefore each term is non-negative, so therefore each of these term must be 0, right. So that means xi, this happens if and only if xi minus yi equals to 0, right. There is square also, so if a square is 0, then xi minus yi is also 0, right. So from here we will see that xi equals to yi. So dxy equals to 0 implies and only implies xi minus yi, xi equals to yi. So this was also easy. Now let's see the third property, that means the symmetry. Symmetry is also trivial, so I'm not going to write much about it. So dxy is dyx because here is square. So xi minus yi square is same as yi minus xi square. So symmetry is also trivial. Now let's move to the fourth property. Let's see the fourth property. So to prove the fourth property, we have to show that the dxy is less than or equals to dxz plus dz y. Okay, so that means we have to show that, right? So we have to show. So this implies that we have to show that summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus yi whole square raised to power 1 by 2 is less than or equals to summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus zi whole square raised to power 1 by 2 plus summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus zi minus yi whole square raised to power 1 by 2. Okay, so here z is what? Z is z1, z2, zn, and this belongs to Rn. Okay, now to show this, let's take the right hand side of this. So I'm taking the right hand side. So and in the right hand side, let xi minus zi equals to ai, and zi minus yi is bi. Okay, so RHS is what? RHS is, so I'm taking the RHS of this and we will prove this result, right? So RHS is summation I equals to 1 to n ai square to the power 1 by 2 plus summation I equals to 1 to n bi square to the power 1 by 2, right? So now and I'm taking the square of the right hand side, right? So the whole square, so this is equals to what? So I will expand this, and after expanding I will get summation I equals to 1 to n ai square plus summation I equals to 1 to n bi square and plus twice of summation I equals to 1 to n ai square whole power 1 by 2 and summation I equals to 1 to n bi square raised to power 1 by 2. And now look at the Cauchy squares inequality. So Cauchy squares inequality is what? This, right? Summation I equals to 1 to n xi square raised to power 1 by 2, and this term is greater than or equals to this, right? So we will use Cauchy squares inequality here. So this term would be greater than or equals to, so this is greater than or equals to summation I equals to 1 to n ai square plus summation I equals to 1 to n bi square, and here we have plus 2, and this is greater than or equals to I equals to 1 to n ai bi, right? Using Cauchy squares inequality. So using Cauchy squares inequality. Okay, now this is what? This is equals to summation I equals to 1 to n ai plus bi whole square, and this is equals to summation I equals to 1 to n ai is what? Ai is xi minus zi and bi is zi minus yi. So we'll get summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus yi. This is square also. So square. And this is what? This is dxy by the definition of dxy. So this means that dxy is less than or equals to the right hand side. So right hand side is this, that means this, right? Square of this, right? So dxz plus dzy square, right? And this implies that this is square, dxy square, right? So this is dxy square. So this implies that dxy is less than or equals to dxz plus dzy. So we have proved all the four properties. Therefore, the metric, this is a metric, and this metric is known as Euclidean metric, right? So this is Euclidean metric. Okay, now let's see the third metric, which is called rectangular metric, and it is defined by dxy equals to summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus yi, and xy belongs to R n, right? So we will show that this is a metric, and it is very easy to show that this is a metric. So you can do it by your own easily. So now we will move to the fourth metric. Now look at the fourth metric. So this metric is defined by dpxy equals to this term, right? Summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus yi, absolute value of xi minus yi to the power p, the whole power 1 by p, where p is greater than or equals to 1. And this d is defined on Rn, right? Rn. Okay, so now, okay, let's see the proof. So first three properties of this of the metric are trivial here, very easy to prove because of this absolute value function, right? Now we will show the fourth property. That means we will show that dpxy is less than or equals to dpxz plus dpzy for xyz belongs to Rn. Okay, so now to show this, that means we have to show that summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus yi to the power p whole power 1 by p, and this is less than or equals to summation 1 to n xi minus zi to the power p whole power 1 by p plus summation I equals to 1 to n zi minus yi to the power p whole power 1 by p, right? Okay, let xi minus yi zi, let's take it, zi is a, I can write this ai, and at xi minus zi is ai, and zi minus yi is bi, then ai plus bi is xi minus zi plus zi minus yi, that means xi minus yi. Therefore,
This implies that summation, that means we have to show that summation I equals to 1 to n xi, sorry, ai plus bi to the power p to the power 1 by p is less than or equals to summation I equals to 1 to n a absolute value of ai p to the power 1 by p plus summation I equals to 1 to n and zi minus yi is absolute value of bi to the power p to the power 1 by p. Okay, so that means to show that this is a matrix, we have to show this, right? We have to show this. Okay, now this is what? Let's look at the Minkowski inequality. Xi plus yi to the power p, 1 by p, and look at this, right? So this is actually Minkowski inequality, and Minkowski inequality is true. So this is Minkowski inequality. So that means this is the fourth property is also satisfied by this matrix. So therefore, by this function, so therefore D is a matrix. Let's look at now a discrete matrix. Discrete matrix is defined by dxy equals to 0 if x equals to y and 1 if x is not equals to y. Okay, so where xy belongs to some any set x, any non-empty set x. Okay, now so let's prove this. So we will prove this result. So so first property is very easy because dxy is either 0 or 1, so dxy is greater than or equals to 0. So dxy is greater than or equals to 0. This is trivial. Second one is dxy equals to 0 if and only if x equals to y. This is also by the definition. And third one is also true. So dxy is same as dyx. This is also trivial. Let's look at the fourth property. So to prove the fourth property, we have to show that dxy is less than or equals to dxz plus dzy. Okay, so in if dxy equals to 0, so there are two cases. If dxy equals to 0, then dxz plus dyz is always greater than or equals to 0, right? Because dxz and dzy, dxz plus dzy is always greater than or equals to 0. So since dxz plus dzy, because this is either 0 or 1, this is either 0 or 1, therefore their sum will be greater than or equals to 0 always. So this is greater than or equals to 0. So if dxy equals to 0, then this implies that dxy is less than or equals to dxz plus dzy. This is this holds in the case when dxy equals to 0. Let's look at the second case when dxy is equals to 1. So this, if dxy equals to 1, then this inequality does not hold if this dxz plus dzy is 0, right? So this inequality does not hold if dxz plus dzy is 0, right? Because this is 1. Okay, so that means both of these dxz and dzy should has to be 0, right? So the dxz and dzy has to be 0. So this means that this means what? That means x equals to z and z equals to y. So that means x equals to y equals to z, but dxy equals to 1, this implies that what, x is not equals to y. So we'll get a contradiction. We will get a contradiction, right? So we have proved this by contradiction. So let me write this. So suppose if possible, dxy is greater than dxz plus dzy, if possible, right? So so this means that, this implies that dxz plus dzy has to be 0, because this is 1, right? So this has to be 0. So this implies that dxz equals to 0 and dzy equals to 0, because this is either 0 or 1 and this is either 0 or 1. So that means both, when both are 0, then only we will get this sum as 0. So this is 0, this is 0. This implies that x equals to z, and this implies that z equals to y. And from here we'll get x equals to y equals to z, right? Which is contradiction. So a contradiction as x is not equals to y from here. So therefore, by contradiction, we can show that we can see that the dxy is always less than or equals to dxz plus dzy. So this is also hold. So that means D is a matrix.